so much, Bala, for that introduction. And hello, everyone, to a great, great welcome to everyone who is joining from the globe. It gives me immense pleasure to be part of OWASP Virtual AppSec this year and to present an amazing talk on why SecDevOps is the new way in cybersecurity. And we'll learn more about what I have researched, what I would want to put across on the table so that everyone may know why security is very important when it comes to the model. So as Bala already mentioned, thank you so much for that introduction again. So I'll just keep it very brief that I have been a DevOps engineer since 2017, and it's been just a quarter that I have now working as a data engineer, working more on the pipelines and how data is important when we tackle them. So that's that. But I was a DevOps engineer in the identity and access management framework. And apart from that, I would just quote myself as a cyber enthusiast, as I am very, very much into this particular domain, very passionate to learn anything here. So these communities come in picture, and I have been an active part since 4 years, since I've started into this industry. I have been part of a lot of communities and have served a lot of time with different aspects of the communities. And this is the list of agenda items which I would be covering today with all of you, whoever has joined in watching this, that, you know, what are the components, what are the different placements we have come across in the recent years when it has come to security development and operations, how we have actually traversed from DevOps to DevSecOps culture, and now why is there a stress on the shift left part? You have, you know, seen those buzz news a lot, and why is it important, and how, you know, after COVID, that particular year, how has things been changed, and how we need more security to be done on the front end side, and more emphasis on how it is necessary to secure all of your environments, what are the different distinct parts of SecDevOps, and then where actually you have to place security when you actually talk about the CI/CD pipeline. That's the basic structuring of it. And how at last, you know, SecDevOps can benefit you. How we'll discuss it, how it is getting you different from the traditional waterfall model. At where all aspects can you push in security and be more secure? Because that's something I consider is not, you know, is something a necessity right now. So yeah, let's deep dive into it. So we already have been a part of a lot of security attacks, you know, and when we just don't go on the technological part, but actually to our home areas where we actually stay, why is security important to us? Why do we secure a lot of items at our home, be it gold, be it cash, be it other contractual documents? Why do we save it? Why do we save it from external forces? Because it's something that is very sensitive to us, very private to us, and that should stay with us. So securing it is very important, and that something is your data, and that can go unprotected. So that is something where security play a role. And apart from your physical lives as well, your digital lives have to be also be secured in ways that nothing goes against you there. So we have seen a lot of things related to security now. So there, these are three different components which we will be traversing all across the presentation. That's development, then we have operations, and then we put across security as well. So we know we have a lot of developers on the ground. They're working, testing, using different languages. They are committing those codes and then pushing it across to different environments, be it from their sandbox to the production environments for those particular tasks. Then there comes the structuring of operations as well, where anything that goes wrong, anything that is something not fitting and is there is something that goes wrong, is where the operations part come into picture, where you fix those things. You again, you know, rewrite those codes, whatever fix has to go, whatever bugs have to be, fixed there, everything gets corrected there as part of operations and how you actually operationalize those particular codes that you have pushed across. But at times, people pay a lot of importance to development and operations, and the security goes behind the table. And that's something which I would be stressing today, that security is very important. In whichever environment you push your codes, you have to have those security tests so that as early as possible, you know what you are sending across, what vulnerabilities it can hold, and that all things we'll discuss when we move forward with the presentation. So these are for the next 2-3 slides, you'll see a lot of, these kinds of diagrams with plus, equals to, with different colors. And I'll just be playing along with people's color, what all colors do you see here? But technically what you have to see in those boxes is certain terms which you would have come across a lot and how they can be interchangeably used. So you have heard, and this actually is the track for it, that is DevSecOps. So when you actually add up development, security, and operations, you get DevSecOps track, where actually you put prioritizing dev first, then security, and then operations, what we have seen it across years now. But we've also seen other terms as where you put operations on the first end, then development, then security. And you can change these notions as per your convenience as well. Like whatever you need first to be on priority is something you put across it on first. And last is something which we are discussing today, is when we put security first and then dev and then operation. That's something I consider that security should be a barging agent on every particular step. It should not be left behind, actually. It should always be there. Like if you just take one step, security should take a step with you there. If you take a step back, then security should also take a step back. So it should be like an agent with you that traverse with you everywhere. So all throughout the years, we have been into the DevOps structuring, where we develop anything and then whatever bugs and fixes comes into picture, we just push it across and, have that operations work as well. Development and certain team is working on the operations part. Whatever things have to be changed, whatever things have to be added there, whatever things have to be, businesses ask you to, better tune it in those particular codes, is something that we have seen from years now. But now we have actually traversed to DevSecOps, where we have actually incorporated security there, and we now push security in all the steps that we have been taking in the DevOps culture. Now we follow the DevSecOps culture, where you can see on the left-hand side that, we code, we test, we build, we plan, then we release, and then the cycle just continues in. And then we put security in the middle, that we have to have that terminology as well, that particular process as well, so that whatever we are testing, committing, and pushing for deployment and, everything, the released codes into different environments, they are also checked thoroughly in terms of security as well, that nothing, no vulnerabilities, nothing non-updated patches or anything gets out of scope there, and you are actually paying attention on that. So this is the basic pipeline that we have followed for years now. That's the CI/CD pipeline. That's continuous integration, continuous deployment pipeline. And we've also added a second D there, that's continuous delivery as well. So we always incorporate that should have continuous integration, then deployment, then delivery, and the process just continues there. So that's the basic process there when a developer actually is committing the changes, then the builds get triggered, then the triggered builds you see, and if there are no errors there, or if there are errors, you run certain kinds of tests there, and you know, whatever outcomes you get, then you push it across to the next environment. If you're doing this in your sandbox environment, and then you push it across to the next environment. And then finally, after those tests and all, everything goes into production. So that's the basic pipeline that you get. And this process actually continues that you integrate, you deploy, then you deliver. Integrate, deploy, deliver. And this just continues in a chain, this particular pipeline. But where are actually the security tests being done in this particular pipeline that we have been following for years now? This is the standard structuring of actually development operations and how you push down your codes. But we don't see any security tests here. And then we come down to the most atrocious parts that, you know, we have seen a lot of cyber attacks, zillion cyber attacks, and these attacks would eventually be in greater numbers in the coming years rather than decreasing, because as technology is advancing every day, so are the cyber attacks, and the cyber criminals are also progressing, and you know, they're advancing every day with different attacks. So the best headline which I could see here on this page is the first one, that cybercrime to cost the world $10.5 trillion annually by 2025. And because of COVID, because everybody is working from home, there were a lots of cyber attacks happening, which a lot of companies actually lost their PI data, red data, a lot of cyber attacks happened there on that end. And a lot of data was stolen there, and the threat actors were gaining a lot of data on that end. So these newses are intact. They just increase by every day. And that is why I stress here, actually, that whatever we are developing and then operationalizing, how is security not playing a role that, you know, we get a lot of cyber attacks here? How can we push security, be more vigilant there, be more inclusive, that with every step you have your security test there? So the next question, it would come like, if we have developers on the ground there, that why is it actually important for us to secure those development environments? Because we work in a lot of environments, like traversing from sandbox to the stage environment to the user acceptance testing, and then probably going down to the production environments. Like, every organization has their own levels of pushing the codes to different environments, and plus different languages and different interfaces being used. So why are we stressing here that those particular environments should be very, very secure, so that, you know, it helps you in certain ways when you push the codes forward? So the first one being, you know, as a developer, when you are working on certain codes, certain environments, then you hold a lot of privilege there. You actually have a lot of access being built up upon you, and to write those codes, to test them in certain environments, to, you know, then provision it to next level. So you hold a lot of access there, and that is why something the developers are on target there, that they should actually incorporate security tests a lot, because we have a lot of social engineering attacks on ground, and phishing being the top of it. And because certain emails which you get, and if you by any chance click on those emails and compromise the sensitive data of your organization, it's done, it's gone, everything is gone. Whatever you have on your cloud, whatever you have on your local systems, on your Git profiles, anything, everything gets tracked there once you have compromised your credentials or your sensitive data. So that is something very important, to actually build those environments where you are giving lesser number of access to people. So the best example here could be you're actually tiering in ways. Like, for example, I have to do certain rights. I have to write a code, test them, and then provision it forward. And you should not be part of that particular procedure. So my organization or my team would make sure that only I have those elevated access into the environment, but you only have normal level of access, not admin level of access onto that environment, so that not everyone has those accesses. So the correct person only has those accesses in the environments they intend to have it. Next is Kubernetes. We have heard a lot about the containerized applications as well, the Docker images that come into play, and you know, a lot of people are working on that. So they also use credentials. There are certain credential sensitive data as well, which when leaked can actually make the cyber criminals gain access to the enterprise data as well. And that's something where we are breaking the rule that, you know, if something we get it across to the cyber criminals, everything we lose. So certain sensitive data we come across, and if certain credentials gets leaked, certain sensitive data gets leaked, then by that, a lot of enterprise data can be accessed through it, and a lot of things can be done, which an external entity should not know about. So developers, the applications you use, everything should be done in ways that you are securing your environments as well. And securing your environments in a way that only the correct people who should have those accesses should have those accesses, and not everyone, so that not everyone can use it. And you know, whoever has the access can judiciously use it. So we just talked about the distinct paths of DevOps. And these are the two distinct paths that I've listed down here. That's security as code and infrastructure as code. So what actually we understand by it, that is security as code and infrastructure as code. So first we'll go by security as code. So like everyone would be aware, or I would just brief it around, that there are a lot of methods that we apply when we have to actually test for certain amount of codes, be it they are static codes or they are running codes. So we actually employ, and we have been using it for years now, that SAST and DAST, that is the static way of testing and the dynamic way of testing. So they are both very handy when used together. They can go a long way because they have their own set of importance there. And here, security as code is, we are actually pushing that word of continuous delivery, that you have your codes and everything, whatever you are actually pushing it across to the environments, and the security is done in ways by those methods. So as you know, if you have a code that is not been released, you can use those static methods of testing it. And if you have a dynamic code, then you use the dynamic set of testing. And there the difference goes a long way, but they work hand in hand together. So that's the first distinct part of SecDevOps, that is security as code. You have to take your codes as continuous delivery, as we have talked about in the CI/CD pipeline, that apart from the continuous integration deployment, there is continuous delivery as well. So that is somewhere security as code work as. The next one is infrastructure as code, and where we actually stress on the point of the deployment part, the controlling of the deployment, hardening of that particular process, how the process goes across. Rather than having manual configurations, you actually automate those things in ways that the code, the infrastructure of the code can be taken from there. So you would have heard of applications like Chef or Ansible, which come into practice of these particular infrastructure as code. And also, rather than going with, writing off scripts there, the manual scripts there, you can actually automate and push these codes likewise. So the basic crux of actually discussing about these two distinct parts is, once we are actually doing continuous delivery via security as code and with infrastructure as code, we are checking the manual configurations and we are working on hardening and controlling the deployment, then actually we come down to a point where we are ready. We are ready, and at very early steps, we can actually identify the vulnerabilities, the issues which pops up there, and we can work on it. So taking your code and, having it explored in different ways is something very important. Your code, your configurations, how you're automating it, how you're pushing it, at what stages can you pop security and can check it in ways that, you can know beforehand that, okay, these lines are not proper, or there is some licensing issue, or there is a outdated software there. So these things are very important to be known beforehand, rather than getting it known at the end step when all the codes are pushed into production and then you get to know about it. So certain issues which I was just talking about was like, there is vulnerable or outdated third-party libraries or softwares on that space. Then there are certain credentials that are directly mentioned in the codes and they can be leaked around. Then you can have a lot of vulnerable Docker-based images as well. And last is licensing issues, that you're using outdated softwares. So the license is, there's some issues there as well. So these are few examples of how your code can be, not in correct proper sense. And it gets really tricky when it gets pushed into production and then you know about it, that, oh no, these issues have come up. Have we got this information earlier? We would have fixed it, but now it will take us a lot of time to actually fix it and everything, because it's already there in the higher environment. So this is one thing and one process which I would actually suggest to actually incorporate security whenever you push it into the higher environments. So, the stages can be different here with every organization, with every developer. But yes, once you see your codes in your own local sandbox environment, you should actually test for the security. Then probably move it to the next stage environment. Then check for the vulnerabilities or any issues or anything, certain tests you want to do on your code again. So with every environment, you're actually giving out those security tests, and then you're making sure nothing will go wrong when it's moved to the higher environment. So security has to go hand in hand with every change you make. And that's certainly not like a process, but it's like a necessity for us now, because security is very, very important for us to have it incorporated with every step of development or operations we make, so that anything which can go wrong, like the four examples, these are not just the four examples, but these are few of the major examples that one can come across. And you should be known to all these things, that they all can actually turn up as well. And if security tests are done everywhere, you're all sorted that, yes, okay, we are sending a green code to production, and we are, at least the security way, the codes are good there. So now we discuss about the benefits, and I assume that, a lot of benefits you would have actually thought of, apart from the four you see on the screen, a lot of things would have come down to your mind if you would have incorporated security with all your steps you do in your DevOps culture, whatever you develop, whatever you operationalize. So with every step, why security is important in the coming days and years and whatever life we cover here, security is very important because that shape would not decrease, would never decrease. I assume it would never decrease. So the first is proficient team. See, to make that team very proficient with the attacks, with the steps and everything, the team should be very much trained. They should have those advanced trainings that one should know how to tackle those things, how you can incorporate, how you can check those security, do those security tests as well. Rather than pushing and committing your codes to the environment, you have to check them. So, you know, setting up a small security team as well, apart from your dev and ops team, a small security team as well that works with the developers whenever a code gets pushed. The team is doing certain kinds of checks on the codes and then gives a green signal and push it to the next environment. So that makes you a proficient team that you're working hand in hand with SecDevOps. And this gives you lesser opportunities of any attacks or any vulnerabilities on your particular codes that you have pushed across into the higher environment. Next is, As I mentioned, there will be more production releases because more emphasis on security when given, more better codes would be released and there'll be more smooth and swift production releases as well. And since we follow the CI/CD pipeline, there'll be continuous integration, continuous deployment, and obviously continuous delivery to our higher environment as well. The third point is very important that we have checked in the previous slide as well, that if we have security at every doorstep of what we do, we are actually giving us time that we are identifying those vulnerabilities at very early stages where it can be thought of, rectified, and worked on, rather than getting to know those vulnerabilities when you are in the higher environment and then not being able to tackle it, or, you know, takes more time to actually recover those data. You can get into your data can, you know, be more and more vulnerable to your organization or to the system or whatever. So if you incorporate security tests there, there'll be early identification of vulnerabilities. And the last very step is automation. When you're actually playing with security as the first and priority step there with all your codes, with whatever you push across to the environment, yes, you are entering into that automation world. You are actually automating things. You code it and then you set up those tests which gets automatically tested on your codes, and then you're pushing it forward rather than doing a lot of manual checks, a lot of manual configurations are done. That is something where you are eradicating the manual step and doing it in an automated way where you better yield productivity, your team becomes more productive in that sense. And that's a sign of happy team when you actually do not encounter any vulnerabilities in your codes and it gets pushed into production environments very nicely and you get no errors there. I guess that's the part where you actually give out a deep sigh and say, okay, my codes are green now in production. There are no vulnerabilities or nothing. Whatever we got off, it was got off at the very early stages only. And I would like to sum up that security is very important as part of the DevOps culture because whatever we are developing, whatever we are operationalizing, one has to realize the importance of security, that it plays a bang-on role with what you actually work on. And these two amazing companies are actually making the most of security as well. They are actually incorporating security as part of their DevOps culture, and it's actually working out for them. So it's like an awareness thing that one should actually be now aware about this, that security has taken a very bad picture in the industry, and because of a lot of cyber attacks and everything, and that is why it has to be pushed on the first level itself. It has to be on the first level, and this way we are actually safeguarding our data, safeguarding our organization, that sensitive data and everything. So that's something is very, very important for us to take care of. These are the two particular references that I would like you people to actually go around and check. These are two blogs that I have read about SecDevOps and DevSecOps, and you would actually understand the importance of how people are actually investing more times into SecDevOps and how that shift left thing can actually help. So these two references are amazing here and has actually woken me up also with things that we have to also take care of as part of this industry. And last, I just want to quote it as Bruce said, that security is not a product, but it's a process, and it's a rigorous process that we have to take care of with all things we develop, with all products we release, with all services we use. That teamwork, that communication, that successful business comes in when you have everything green. Nothing gets leaked out. So security is a process. We have to live with it. It's not something we can eradicate from our processes. No, it's very important, and it stands there as something very important for us to take care of. So thank you so much, everyone, to who all are watching me right now. I hope you got a good picture of what I thought of and have researched about security and how does this placement actually work. So I'll be happy to connect with you people on my below handles, Twitter, LinkedIn, happy to discuss more on your thoughts, how you think about it, and any questions I'm happy to take here. So thank you. Pala, over to you.